We want to solve the given absolute value equations. The first step in solving an absolute value equation is to isolate the absolute value. Notice for the first equation, the absolute value is already isolated. We have the absolute value of 3x equals 18. The second step is to set up and solve two equations based upon the absolute value principle. So looking back at this equation, the absolute value of a number is the number's distance from zero, and distance is always positive. So for this equation, because the absolute value of negative 18 equals 18, or the absolute value of positive 18 is equal to 18, the expression 3x can equal negative 18, or it can equal positive 18, and the absolute value will still be equal to positive 18. So the first equation we need to solve is 3x equals negative 18, or the second equation is 3x equals 18. Solve for x, we divide both sides by 3. Simplifying, we get x equals negative 6, or dividing both sides by 3 here, we get x equals positive 6. So the absolute value equation has two solutions, x equals negative 6, or x equals positive 6. Let's perform substitution into the original equation to verify both solutions are correct. So we'll first substitute negative 6 for x, which should give us the absolute value of 3 times negative 6 equals 18. This would be the absolute value of negative 18 equals 18. And the absolute value of negative 18 is 18, so we have 18 equals 18, which is a check to verify x equals negative 6 is a solution. And now we'll check x equals 6. So we have the absolute value of 3 times 6 equals 18, which should give us the absolute value of positive 18 equals 18. And the absolute value of 18 is 18, so again we have 18 equals 18, verifying our solution is correct. Now let's look at our second absolute value equation. Notice for this equation, the absolute value is not isolated, so let's first isolate the absolute value. So we begin with the equation 2/3 times the absolute value of x equals 4. On the left side, we have 2/3 times the absolute value of x. So to isolate the absolute value, instead of dividing both sides by 2/3, we'll multiply by the reciprocal of 3/2. So we'll multiply the left side by 3/2 and the right side by 3/2. Now we'll simplify. 3/2 times 2/3 is equal to 6, 6, or 1. 1 times the absolute value of x equals the absolute value of x equals, on the right side, let's write 4 as 4 over 1. Notice 2 and 4 share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2s and 4. Notice now this is just 3 times 2, which equals 6. Now that we've isolated the absolute value, we need to set up and solve two equations. Again, the reason for this is because we know the absolute value of negative 6 is equal to 6, or the absolute value of positive 6 is equal to 6, which means the expression inside the absolute value, in this case just x, can equal negative 6, or it can equal positive 6. So our two equations are x equals negative 6, or x equals positive 6. And notice how these two equations are already solved for x, and therefore these are the two solutions to the given absolute value equation. Let's go ahead and check this, though, by performing substitution into the original equation. For x equals negative 6, we'd have 2/3 times the absolute value of negative 6 equals 4. The absolute value of negative 6 is 6, so we have 2/3 times 6 equals 4. Looking at this product here, let's write 6 as 6 over 1. 3 and 6 share a common factor of 3. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 2, 3s, and 6. Notice how the left side is just 2 times 2, which equals 4. So we have 4 equals 4, which is always true. So this verifies x equals negative 6 is a solution. And now we'll check x equals positive 6. When x equals positive 6, we have 2/3 times the absolute value of positive 6 equals 4, which again gives us 2/3 times 6. Again, simplifying like we did before, there's 1, 3, and 3, and 2, 3s, and 6. The left side is 2 times 2, which equals 4, giving us 4 equals 4, which is true. Verifying x equals 6 is also a solution. I hope you found this helpful.